Good morning students, I welcome you all to today's class. In this class I am going to discuss with you about vegetative and asexual reproduction in xylotem. Xylotem sporophytic plant body reproduces by two methods. One is the vegetative reproduction and another one is the asexual reproduction. Let's start with vegetative reproduction. In case of the xylotem, vegetative reproduction takes place by the formation of gamete on rhizome. Gamete is also called as the brood bodies. Vegetative reproduction in xylotem takes place by the formation of gamete or brood bodies which are produced on the surface of the rhizome. Let us move towards the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the main method of reproduction in sporophytic generation. It takes place by the formation of the spores. Xylotem produces only one kind of spores, hence it is called as homosporous in nature. Spores are produced in the specialized structure called as the synangium. Asexual reproduction is the main method of reproduction in the sporophytic generation of xylotem. It takes place by the formation of these spores. Here the xylotem produces only one kind of spores. That condition is called as the homosporous condition. These spores are produced in the specialized structure called as the synangium. Synangium is present in the axils of the bifid foliar appendages. It is trilobed externally and trilocular internally. It has a short multicellular stalk at the base. Synangium is produced by the xylotem and it is produced at the axils of the bifid foliar appendages. These are appear like trilobed externally, and if you take the section it shows the trilocular condition internally. It has a short multicellular stalk at the base. This is the structure of synangium. If you take the TS of synangium, synangium internally shows the three locules. Each locule represents a sporangia. Hence, synangium is the united product of three sporangia. The chambers are filled with the spores. Only one kind of spores are produced in xylotem. Hence, it exhibits the homosporous condition. The synangium wall is externally covered by multi-layered nature and it is protective in condition. TS of synangium. Synangium internally shows three locules and each locule represents a sporangia. Hence, synangium is the united product of three sporangia. The chambers are filled with the spores. Only one kind of spores are produced in case of the xylotem, that is, it exhibits the homosporous condition. It is having an multi-layered wall which protects the synangium. Let's move towards the spores. Spores are reniform in shape. Each spore has the wall which consists of two layers, outer exine and inner intine. On one surface of the spore, a median slit is present. Spores are reniform in shape. Each spore has a wall which consists of two layers, that is, outer exine and inner intine. On one surface of the spore, a median slit is present. Let us move towards the theories or views about the morphology of spore producing complex in xylotem. There are three views about the morphology of spore producing structure in xylotem. The first view says that synangium is the modified colline, that is nothing but it is the modified stem. According to second view, this is that synangium is the modified leaf or it is the foliar modification. According to the third view of the scientists, they said that synangium is neither stem modification nor foliar modification. Such view is considered as organ sui generis. This is very important for 1 marks, that is organ sui generis. According to this, they say that it is neither the modification of stem nor the modification of leaf. Opinion of Bearhurst. According to him, spore producing structure in xylotem is not sporangium but it is synangium. His studies revealed that fruiting body of xylotem is developed from three separate sporangial initial and the internal structure shows three separate vascular traces, so that he says that it is not sporangia, it is synangium. This is about the vegetative reproduction and asexual reproduction in case of the xylotome. Thank you.